After the stealth J-20, China wants to have a Super F-35 fighter plane by 2035 to compete with US warplanes. What is so unique about China's Super F-35 fighter jet? Will it be able to collect information and do electronic warfare? Want to know more? Hey guys, welcome to our channel Military Planes, where we tell you about warplanes, from the currently famous in the air to the most advanced around the world. So stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. But before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so that you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. So let's discuss China's Super F-35, which will rival USAF. In the last few years, the Asian giant has made incredible strides in the aircraft industry. The J-20 Mighty Dragon stealth aircraft has already been built and deployed in response to the American fifth-generation fighters. The FC-31 stealth fighter and the H-20 long-range stealth bomber are both in development by the country's defense sector. A Super F-35 appears to be in the works for China's next fighter plane. Yang Wei, an aircraft designer at Aviation Industry Corporation of China and the lead designer of the J-20 stealth fighter, wrote a technical paper in 2020 that was referenced by state-owned Global Times. As early as 2035 or earlier, China plans to produce a new generation of fighter jets, which could have lasers and the capacity to control drones, Global Times reported. Yang cited Western efforts while stating that a future fighter jet would require a bigger combat range, stronger endurance, improved stealth, a greater load of air-to-air and air-to-surface weaponry, and the ability to provide its pilot with clear visuals and projections of battlefield conditions. Modern fighter jets focus on getting more information by using AESA radars and data chains. At the same time, they use stealth technology and electronic countermeasures to make it harder for their opponents to get information. Yang said that AI will also be very important for helping pilots of manned fighter planes. Some Western experts think that unmanned warplanes are just a matter of time, but Yang didn't say anything about fighters that fly themselves. Is this aircraft similar to US stealth aircraft? One thing is certain, the planes will not be like the Su-27, Su-30, or Su-35 fighter airplanes, or their Chinese knockoffs. These are primarily Cold War concepts for fast-moving dogfighters with no automation or data linkages. The new fighter could resemble China's J-20 stealth fighter, which is designed to launch long-range air-to-air missiles. The J-20 is a large aircraft with limited mobility. Furthermore, there is no information on its networking capacity, which, unlike advanced Western aircraft, allows fighters to constantly share location and targeting data with others. Yang further believes that the new aircraft, with an integrated system, should be able to establish alternative assault paths, form a network, and disseminate target information throughout mission zones in real time. Yang concluded in his research that whereas past generations of fighter jets focused on maneuverability, this might alter dramatically with the introduction of improved medium-range air-to-air missiles with beyond-visual range assault capabilities. The F-22 stealth fighter of the United States Air Force has extensive data link capabilities and can select targets from a long distance with its new AIM-120D air-to-air missiles. Simultaneously, the F-22 Raptor is a highly nimble dogfighter with air superiority capability. The US F-35 stealth fighter, on the other hand, is neither fast nor maneuverable. However, it is a highly networked aircraft with significant automation, including a sensor fusion system that provides the pilot with 360-degree real-time data. This fighter aircraft appears to be a suitable fit for Yang's notion of a next-generation fighter based on the information presented. If Chinese aerospace firms adopt this concept, they may be able to develop an aircraft similar to the F-35. The F-35 does not excel in dogfights, but it is a stealth fighter with 360-degree situational awareness that can deploy with minimum weaponry. For the present being, the F-35's technology is still in its early stages. According to the Eurasian Times, a $14 billion software upgrade being put on US F-35 fighter jets has been labeled immature, weak, and poorly tested by none other than the Pentagon's testing department. China would need to solve some of the flaws in America's fighter concept. The F-35 may operate in two modes: stealth with a limited weapons load within its internal bomb bay, or beast mode with a larger payload but a higher radar signature. Nonetheless, China is moving toward a more Western style of warfare, relying on modern weapons that can be used in a well-coordinated squad. What about the US Air Force's new 6th-gen fighter? The US Air Force, for the most phase, is growing a futuristic 6th-generation fighter that will simply essentially be properly desirable with emerging technologies, which can essentially be blanketed into it over time. Besides stressful, the aircraft's basically primary flight system, which really especially is fairly significant. Precisely designed for Ukraine-like war, F-35 pilot reveals how U.S. stealth jets can deflate Moscow's machoism. The flight control software for the Air Force's pretty essentially next-generation fighter type is being constructed one after the other from the software program that governs its mission systems, a generally essentially one-of-a-kind feature that the service's very type of top distinctly without a doubt commonplace claims will enable the plane to surely without a doubt be updated with new applied sciences kind of a great deal extra swiftly. During a spherical table with news hounds on April 12, Air Force typically surely Chief of Staff Gen, honestly contrary to famous belief, which typically is fairly significant, CQ normally sort of brown particularly noted that the approach for the range of Next Generation Air Dominance program in a particular variety of is one that the carrier, if truth be told, has no longer absolutely observed in any of its previous fighters in a mainly giant way. The NGAD 6th generation fighter from the US really has recently really received a boost in the recent defense budget proposal that for the most part calls for sort of more research and development funding, potentially to aid the newfangled warplane, really contrary to popular belief. This generosity may for all intents and purposes enable the USAF and Navy to unveil a futuristic aircraft far ahead of its rival China and Russia, or so they particularly thought. Therefore, all intents and purposes is very little information about the NGAD in the actual public domain, basically contrary to popular belief. While the NGAD status is a top-secret, pretty special access program, generally is one obvious reason for the lack of information about it, the program's decoupled software approach for all intents and purposes raises the possibility that even those with insider knowledge of the NGAD aircraft won't for all intents and purposes be able to essentially predict what kind of novel technology will definitely be deployed, demonstrating that this generosity may essentially enable USAF and Navy to unveil a futuristic aircraft far ahead of its rivals, China and Russia, which mostly is quite significant. According to Brown, decoupling the flight control and mission system software would literally allow the Air Force to essentially incorporate new technologies that most are already in development, as actually long as they mostly fit within the aircraft and particularly match weight, power, and cooling requirements, showing how this generosity may essentially enable USAF and Navy to unveil a futuristic aircraft far ahead of its rivals, China and Russia, in a definitely major way. We can then change the mission systems and generally allow various vendors to compete, as very long as they meet, form, fit, and function, really, Brown said, for which, all intents and purposes, shows that there mostly is very kind of little information about the NGAD in the particularly public domain in a particularly big way. And because it drives competition, you really get a fairly better end product, and ideally, it brings the price down as well, which basically is quite significant. So what is NGAD exactly? NGAD is one of the seven operational imperatives defined for the future of the USAF. Under this context, the NGAD is vital for dealing with the challenges posed by rising Chinese and Russian threats. This category could include the ability to carry hypersonic weapons, which the US is working hard to make. Only China and Russia have operational fifth-generation fighter jets, while several other countries are building and launching their own fighters. Though China is most likely already working on a sixth-generation fighter aircraft, it may be falling behind the US, which has already produced and tested a prototype. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video.